What's up, YouTubers? It's Mike here. Once again with some groundbreaking evidence in regards to an intentional effort to create a sizable event at the New Madrid seismic zone. This is damning evidence. Of course, it's always damning when you're on the other side of the fence doing all the dirty work. And anyhow, if you haven't heard of me, then I'd say the media is doing their job and keeping your focus away from these events. And if you have heard of me, it's thanks to the YouTubers who all collaborate in an effort together to spread the truth about what's happening. And so, in having said that, I ask anybody who sees this video to pass this on to as many people as earthly possible. Re-upload this video to your channel. Do whatever it is you got to do to get this information out. This is how dire this information is. If something was happening to our world, which it is, and I'll do a brief overview on it. However, if something was happening to our world that was so major that it affected the entire population, would you not want to try to tell as many people as possible? Why do you think the mainstream media has gone quiet? They've gone hush-hush on everything. You know, it's awfully strange that the media picked up the story at the beginning of the year of all these animals dying, and then 1 week into it, there was that event in Arizona, and then their focus shifted altogether, and they haven't said not one single peep about this since. However, reports continue to pour in from around the world. Media reports, personal reports, with evidence that thousands upon thousands of animals are still dropping dead. What the hell is going on here, people? This should ring a bell for you, okay? This should ring a bell. So let's get started on this brief overview here. I first reported at the beginning of the year that the first three animal kill zones coincided with the antenna array configuration for the software used by Digisonde receivers that are utilized by HARP and other such ionospheric heaters. And in this picture, I show the three die-off locations are at the 120-degree angle from each other and define the perimeter of the most active region of the New Madrid Fault. The HARP antennas calibrate signals using a 120-degree radiating angle from the center point. The Digisonde computes comparative signal strength along with each ray of the antenna for directional tuning. Okay? Now, I'm not going to go into depth on this stuff because, well, if you really need to see it all, you can go back on my channel and look at the videos. But I do want to give a brief overview. We'll skip on to the next picture here. And this pretty much shows the three towns that first started off the animal die-offs: Gilbertsville, Kentucky, BB, Arkansas, and LaBar, Louisiana. And it shows the focal point in between the 120-degree area, and it just so happens that that focal point sits right above the most active region of the New Madrid seismic zone. Okay, so and having said all that, let me go ahead and get this next picture up. Sorry, my screen capture software slows my computer down. Right here we have the locations of Digisonde receivers around the world. Okay. And I'm sure this isn't all of them, but these are the ones that are reported. So, and then when you put in the animal die-offs, and I'm sure this has been updated since, anywhere these Digisonde receivers line up is where there have been animal kills. So, and moving on, this is a map used by produced by Edgar Cayce and used by the Air Force. It's called the Navy, I'm sorry. It's now used for, I guess, to show soldiers what the coastlines of America will look like. And if you have a hard time believing that, I want you to pay real close attention to the center of the United States here. That's the Mississippi Valley. Okay, this is what Edgar Cayce had projected. Now I'm going to show you a real-time picture, like an updated computer image of the same event. You see that? Now, do you let me go right here, and do you see this? This is about the area that BP oil well was drilling, and you see where that rift or fault line comes out at Louisiana and Mississippi. Well, that oil rig was drilling not too far from there, and where it drilled actually created a big amount of instability in this fault zone. So, and having said that, I'll move on to the next picture. Okay. This right here, now we're connecting the dots here. This is important, and I still hadn't got to the damning evidence yet, so y'all stay with me, okay? It's important we know all this stuff. This has to do with FEMA camps. Okay? Now I'm gonna read this paragraph. Halliburton has been awarded a contract announced by the Department of Homeland Security, United States Immigration and Customs Enforcement component. The indefinite delivery, indefinite quantity contingency contract is to support ICE facilities and has a maximum total value of $385 million over a 5-year term. The contract provides for establishing temporary detention and processing capabilities in the event of an emergency influx of immigrants into the United States or to support the rapid development of new programs. Excuse me. Okay, well, we all know that's a cover. That gives them a reason to go ahead and build these facilities and leave them laying empty until they're actually used and filled up by people like who? Us. Moving on. Let's connect the dots with the FEMA coffins from a few years back. We all thought the FEMA coffins were put there because of the swine flu. They were made because of the swine flu. Now I'm starting to see this is bullshit. Excuse my French, guys. I'm sorry. I'm a little excited about all of this news, not in a good way either. So you just have to bear with me in my language. I'm not out here trying to please one person or another. I'm just trying to get the news out. So bear with me. Anyhow, a company, Vantage Corporation in North Georgia, was awarded a contract to build all of these coffins. Okay? Notice Vantage with the symbolism in their name there. You see that? Anyways, the Illuminati are big on symbolism. And they're also big on hints. But anyways, this company was awarded a contract to build all of these FEMA coffins. We all thought it was for the swine flu. Well, guess how wrong we were. And I did witness myself these coffins being transported through Indiana, which also lays on a New Madrid fault zone. Right here, we'll show you pictures of the coffins being stored in Georgia. And right here, we see, well, this is more back towards the FEMA camps here. This is Swift Luck Green's Department of Homeland Security in Central Wyoming and Maximum Security Facility. But anyways, going back to the coffins here, this is North Georgia where they're storing hundreds upon hundreds of thousands of these coffins. There's a reason for these. You know, there's a reason that each coffin can hold up to 3 or 4 bodies. All right, they're not going to be nice and neat about it. It's going to be sloppy work, and bodies are going to get stashed in these things and burned off. Something's going on. Okay, these coffins were not, or I'm sorry, supposed coffin liners were not ordered, and this company was not contracted to make these for no reason. Well, now that reason is taking on a face that we can actually see. It's not just a mystery now, okay? So bear with me. All these FEMA trains that were once talked about here a while back, well, they're gonna use those things, okay? Those things are gonna be used. Now, I'm not sure if the picture that I'm depicting here is the actual train, but I do know and have seen pictures of these rail cars with rows of bench seats in them, and rails right above the seats. And to me, that indicates a place to handcuff somebody as they sit and are transported. And the thing you got to remember is the Illuminati and Freemasons, they're all about giving off hints to events, okay? And you got to remember, President Biden has been doing all of the hinting since the Obama campaign took the presidency. In the beginning of the campaign, when they first were awarded the seat of the President of the United States, Obama clearly stated, okay, or I'm sorry, not Obama, Joe Biden clearly stated that this was going to be a train-friendly administration. That's kind of like rubbing it in your face right there without giving it away, don't you think? He also stated that this administration was going to be tested in an extreme manner. And I am pretty sure he was referring to the events that we're about to face. So anyways, having said that and showed you these pictures, I'd like to take you to some articles that I've been reading here as of lately. And with these articles, I'm going to show you the new proof. First off, animal deaths are still being reported across the world. Okay? We've got Beijing, China reporting all kinds of dead birds. And you know, in the article it says that it says that they've died of starvation and unfavorable weather conditions. I think that's BS, and I'm going to call them on it. They're twisting, you know, all around the world, there's a different reason for every group of animals that